It's useless to try to sleep. Every time I close my eyes, I can feel the demons of my past pounce on me threateningly and plunge me into a suffocating darkness from which I cannot escape. I thought I had defeated them. I finally thought I had left them behind. But with the reunion of my brother Georgie, all the memories I thought were buried have resurfaced. Finding out that my brother is a murderer is something that sadly has not surprised me, since everything we experienced in that damn farm with the Stannings certainly traumatizes us. Oh God, it was horrible. I can still feel the fine straws sticking to my skin when that wretched couple made us sleep in the barn, or how the frozen water they threw on us in winter soaked my bones. Was truly inhuman. How could they send us there? I was not surprised when I wake up one morning and Georgie was not there anymore. After the death of our brother, caused by the abuse of that hateful couple, Georgie was no longer the same. The happy and playful boy I knew became an introverted and analytic child. From that moment on, I knew that behind that distressed look, there was an insatiable thirst for revenge. But I really do not blame him. Knowing what we lived, it was to be expected that our lives would be tainted by sin and devil. I sincerely do not complain. I know that my adoptive parents did the impossible in order to make me feel loved and cared. But he was already too broken for that. And this was reflected in many other aspects of my life, such as excesses. I began to drink a glass of scotch at night. It made me avoid the demons of my dreams. But this isolated action that I thought was unimportant became a habit from which I could not get rid. Cheers. Although I have been able to hide it in most cases, this addiction has endangered my social status. I can still remember the day I came home, drunk, with another girl on my arm. If I concentrate hard, I can feel the burning after the slap my father gave me when he saw us. After this incident, my relationship with them cooled down considerably, and so I went out in search of the only blood family I had left, my brother. It is ironic that after so much effort to find him, I was the one who locked him up in that loony bin. But I did it for the simple reason that if someone else had taken care of it, God knows where they would have taken him. No. No, I cannot afford to lose track of him again. Not now that I need him with me to accept our revenge. I was very careful to choose the center where they took him. A place with morally weak workers, sinners by nature, who would not hesitate for a second to accept a large sum of money as an anonymous donation. Did they really think that after finding my brother, I could leave him lying there like garbage after the hell we lived through together? I don't think so. As soon as I can, I will get him out of there. Together, we will avenge our brother's death and make those who made us suffer pay for the sins. For if the law does not punish sinners, it is up to us to take justice into our own hands. Do not worry, dear brother. No, nothing and no one can separate us. It is a divine law that dictates the Bible, Mark 10:9. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no one separate.